Hey, how's it going, everybody? Kaiju Lou here.
And Sega Sean.
And welcome to Zone 16 of the Super Game Strikers podcast, the official podcast of...
Game Strikers.
First things first, we have our video game fun fact of the week, and Sega Sean is going to share it concerning some Sonic music.
Yeah, the other day, funny enough, I was watching a video on YouTube, from WatchMojo, I might as well say it, where they were listing the top 10 worst pieces of video game music. And Sonic was on the thumbnail, so I checked it out, and I did not know this, but, well, I expected Sonic Chronicles to be on the list. But when they were talking about Sonic Chronicles, they brought up the fact that the reason why the music is just so boring and bland and doesn't even take advantage of the DS at all was because that BioWare actually lost its contract, or I should say ended its contract with Sega near the end of the development of Sonic Chronicles. Therefore, which I don't know the reason why they didn't say, but therefore the reason why the music is so crappy is because that is the placeholder music that they put in the game when starting development. So that's why it's so barren, empty, and boring. But I didn't know that, and well, now you guys know too.
All right, that's really cool. So here is, that is your video game fun fact of the week. And speak of the devil, first things first is some Sonic news. As you guys know, last Thursday on June 23rd was Sonic's 25th anniversary. So that was
a blast.
That was big. And if you guys want to hear some more, have some more fun with it, be sure to check out our 25th anniversary special Sonic podcast. And a lot of pieces of other Sonic news as well. The new Sonic game has been heard that it won't be out till 2017.
Yeah, that's right. Pretty shocking. Well, not really shocking to me, but I know a lot of people were hoping for a new game to come out this year. But honestly, you have the Mario and Sonic at the Olympics, as well as, boom, Fire and Ice. So I kind of expected that, but this means more time on the game, and that is good. More development and stuff. Don't be mad. But I will say that I'm expecting on the July 22nd party in San Diego, maybe they might reveal what it's going to look like. Maybe a trailer of some sort. That doesn't mean the game's going to be announced, but who knows.
And I guess that, when is LEGO Dimensions coming out? Because didn't they say that Sonic won't be in LEGO Dimensions till next year?
Yeah, 2017.
So will that mean LEGO Dimensions won't come out till next year?
LEGO Dimensions
next
is
year
coming,
or what?
LEGO Dimensions is coming out this fall, but the Sonic Pack or whatever it's going to be is going to be coming out in 2017, apparently. So, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So he's DLC.
Well, not DLC. The certain packs come out at different times or whatever. I don't know what else is coming out in 2017, but yeah.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Last Friday, Eggman took over Sonic's Twitter account.
Yeah.
So we had it uploaded.
Yeah.
I believe it was yesterday or a couple of days ago. Sean uploaded the full 10-minute spiel of Sonic and Eggman, Roger Craig Smith and Mike Pollock, talking, answering a handful of questions, a lot of them from famous people.
Yeah.
Like Xavier Woods from WWE, Game Grumps, even Assassin's Creed,
yeah,
and Sega themselves. Mm-hmm. So it's a whole lot of fun. If you guys want to check it out, go right ahead. We have it
have it uploaded, so yeah.
And yeah, and also people who have played the demo for Sonic and Boom Fire and Ice. Apparently, Sega Sean found out that people have given it good responses to it.
Yeah.
Or positive reviews on it.
Yeah, it looks like it's really trimmed down the fat from Shattered Crystal on the 3DS that came out. I think it's been 2 years now, and people are really happy. It's putting a more emphasis on speed, which is what people love. There's a lot less exploration and stuff, but it's a lot more, it looks a lot nicer. There's tons of music and stuff. It feels like this may redeem the Boom name, so hopefully people are willing to accept it.
Oh, okay, so they fixed a lot of its patches.
Yeah, they basically took all the fan feedback from Shattered Crystal, put it into this game, delayed the game until, well, now, because it was supposed to come out last year in November, but they delayed it a whole year until now to work on it even more, and I think that's the right choice. That's the way to go right there. So I have seen some gameplay of it. It's good. It looks really fun. I didn't mind Shattered Crystal, to be honest. I know it had its problems, but it was way better than the Wii U one, Rise of Lyric. So hopefully, you know, people just won't diss this game because it's got the Sonic Boom name. There could be some good in it, and I think so.
And this is going to be only available for 3DS?
Yes, 3DS.
How come this is not having a Wii U release?
Maybe because of the reception that Rise of Lyric had on the Wii U and stuff. It might be something like that. But plus, Big Red Button were the ones who made the game, not exactly Sega. Sega just published it. So Big Red Button, I don't think they're doing very good after that first release, which was Boom, of all things. So they might be in a little trouble, so I don't think they're even going to put much emphasis on it, but yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, on to some Nintendo news. Once again, Sonic at the top of the news. Mario and Sonic at the 2016 Rio Olympic Games just came out.
Yeah.
And finally for the Wii U. And I believe that the 3DS version has been out.
Yeah, it's been
Why
out
Why was it out 3 months before the Wii U version?
I don't know. This
Why...
isn't...
I just remembered that.
Yeah.
It came out way back in March.
Yeah, yeah.
For the 3DS.
It's kind of odd, but this isn't the first time it's happened. I believe the 3DS one usually is the first one to come out for some reason. I don't know why, but the Wii U one is looking really good. I don't know how the 3DS one was received. I think it was received pretty well, but this time they have a lot more emphasis on story. In the console version, usually you'd leave it up to the 3DS version to have more of a story thing, but now the console version even has more story aspects. There's a hub world and stuff, and the graphics look pretty darn good. It's got that Nintendo polish, and it's just hilarious how this game has more content than a lot of recent Nintendo games, say like Mario, what was that tennis game called? Mario Tennis?
Mario Tennis Open?
Was it called that? For the Wii U?
I don't know. I just remember my 3DS having a puzzle piece
for
a tennis game called Mario Tennis Open.
No, that was for the 3DS. There was another one. I forgot. But that game, Animal Crossing, the Amiibo Festival and stuff, it's kind of funny to see this game, which people usually diss and stuff like that, have way more content than, yeah. But it looks really fun. I can't wait to get it.
All right, cool. A lot of new sports, I'm sure, have been added
rugby?
To this thing.
Rugby. Have you ever seen rugby played?
I know what rugby is, yeah.
It's pretty intense, especially for the game. Like, it is very interesting.
It's a mix of football and soccer put together. It's soccer, but you tackle each other.
Yeah, yeah.
You beat the crap out of each other.
I've never seen it, and there's, like, so much involved with it or whatever. It's like, okay, this is really interesting. And then you also have soccer in there. I think they had that before, but it wasn't as well done. The soccer aspect is like Mario Strikers, so hey, everybody loves Mario Strikers. It's in our name. So, Strikers, so, yeah.
Is the boxing thing new?
Boxing is new to console.
Because I remember you posting that gif of Eggman punching out Sonic, and
yeah.
Everyone was blown away by it.
It's fun. It looks really fun.
So, was this the first time boxing has appeared in this game?
I think it's the second time, but in the 3DS version. I don't know if it was in the first Mario and Sonic at the Beijing. The first one on the 3DS. I don't remember if it was that. But this one, I think, is a lot more fleshed out. Like, you can actually throw punches. Before, I think it was just, like, tapping on the screen. But this time, you know, you get to throw punches and stuff. So, can't wait to have a couple boxing matches.
All right, then. Also, on that same day, which was last Friday, not only did Mario and Sonic at the Rio de Janeiro Olympic Games came out, but also Tokyo Mirage Sessions Fire Emblem, or hashtag Fire Emblem, for the Wii U as well, came out that day. And it looks cool. It's had good reviews so far.
Yeah, really.
And like I said, it's a crossover between Shin Megami Tensei and Fire Emblem, both popular Japanese series of RPG games. And it's pretty much a story where the spirit of the Fire Emblem characters show up to these Tokyo high school kids.
I didn't know that.
And because there's these evil spirit-like creatures around called mirages that take away people's energies, or they call it their performa. Oh. And they steal your performa as well as they're responsible for the disappearances of people, and these kids got to stop them, and this organization.
Getting crazier.
In this organization, and they all obtain the spirit of Fire Emblem characters to fight these people, these mirages.
Oh, do you know what characters from Fire Emblem are in there? Or?
I see the cover. The guy looks like Crom.
Yeah, Crom or Marth.
He looks like I don't know, blue hair.
Yeah.
Probably Crom or Marth, because they're the main characters. I'm not sure. And I see another girl. I think it might be Lucina. I don't know.
I don't know. They look like
them. It's probably going to be the big name Fire Emblem characters.
Yeah.
So, probably so.
If you're into that stuff, go get it.
I'll probably get it, but probably not anytime soon. Probably during price reduction. I don't know.
Yeah, I think it might be a game to wait for price to go down, because I'm unsure of it. I know you're kind of like... So, yeah.
Yeah, and I still got Fire Emblem Fates to handle.
Yeah.
So, yeah. New information and news on Pokemon Sun and Moon is supposed to be coming out on July 1st, which is this coming Friday.
Oh, okay.
And so, yeah, who knows? Maybe they'll reveal more Pokemon. Maybe they'll have, I don't know, more gameplay features to show off. Who knows? It's Pokemon, so right now they got a lot of things up their sleeves.
They're really updating this a lot, huh? We got news every
and
month.
We still got all the way till November for this game to come out. So this might not be the final piece of update news.
I doubt it, yeah.
So yeah. Devil's Third, the Wii U game, their online multiplayer will be closing on December 28th.
Oh, what a loss.
And my first impression was, wasn't it that one Wii game that got a crap ton of bad reviews for every reason across the map?
Yeah.
Graphics, story, everything, gameplay, and it got really rare for some reason.
Yeah, because there was hardly any production on it.
And it got expensive as hell, and I don't know. I guess no major loss there.
Yeah.
But it's weird, I don't know, because people in Japan praise this game. Mm. They all love it, but here in the North, they completely, I don't know what the word is.
Did you know if this was a... It. Yeah, was this a...
Shunned game? It.
Shunned it. Did you know that this was a game, like, for other systems before it came to Wii U?
I think it's on another system. I think it was on Microsoft.
I think so.
Or Windows.
Because when I was looking for a trailer, which you're going to be seeing right now, when I was looking for a trailer, though, not this trailer, but when I was looking for one...
So I think this is only the Wii U's online. I think the other online is still going to be available.
Yeah, yeah.
Don't quote me on that. I'm not sure.
You sure? You're not sure. All right. Oh, the source is gone.
You know, I don't really have the sauce on that, but I don't give a shit. Tons of Amiibo news. Metroid Prime Federation Force is confirmed to have Amiibo support. So, which means, will Metroid Prime have their own line of Amiibos as well?
I don't think
besides so. Them saying, okay, these other Amiibos are compatible. But when you look at Legend of Zelda or something, they got their own line of Amiibos. And you can use the Wolf Link, which is an older Amiibo for that.
Oh, that would have been a good way to celebrate the
anniversary. Even Kirby Planet Robobot. Even though they said every single Amiibo is compatible with it, but they still had their own line as well. So it might happen.
When is Metroid Federation Force coming? November?
I actually completely forgot.
I think November. There's still time to announce it, but that would be honestly a great way to give back to Metroid, because this is an anniversary year, right? So
I believe so.
Yeah, they should have done that. They should have had like a Ridley.
There's been no love for Metroid at all.
Hey, this looks like a good game. No, it looks like an okay game. People are saying it's not that bad. It's just that you're getting this as an anniversary game, I guess.
It already got condemned because they said Samus is not in there.
Yeah.
No Samus, no Likey.
What's going on? Oh, well. What are you going to do?
And also, not just that, but tons of Amiibos are heading our way. Like I said, the possible Metroid Prime Amiibos. Possible.
Possible.
There's the new line of Super Mario Amiibos, 8 of them.
Oh god, I forgot about them actually. I'm like, oh.
Let's see. There's Waluigi's finally getting his Amiibo.
Finally.
New Wario Amiibo, Rosalina, Daisy is getting her own Amiibo. New Donkey Kong and Diddy Kong, Boo, and I forgot who the 8th guy was.
Did you say Rosalina? Or?
Yes, I did.
Dry Bones.
Maybe.
He's getting... Is he one of them?
Maybe. Okay. I don't know. What do you... We have an interesting story about that, remember? With the sellout thing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Wario.
Yeah. Well, not only... when they announced it, apparently all of them went up for pre-order online. They sold out within an hour.
Well, obviously.
Well, because... I'm just like, wow. And then... Because we were checking it out. And then in the second wave, Wario was immediately gone. So I'm pretty sure they restocked them again, which is good, but that scared us there for a minute. That honestly did.
So yeah, you got your Super Mario Brothers amiibos, Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild amiibos, there's three of those things, and all that. And we still have to wait for the Cloud, Corn, and Bayonetta amiibos.
Who knows when that's coming out?
For the complete Smash line. Like I said, I'm calling it for the fall. That's probably going to come out.
Oh.
And
I think maybe Cloud might come later.
And also next Friday on July 8th, Callie and Marie amiibos will be coming out for Splatoon.
Yes, yes.
As well as the new recolors of the three-pack of Inkling Boy, Inkling Girl, and Inkling Squid.
Yes,
but yes, next Friday.
Oh, shit. Are you ready? Oh, Callie and Marie.
And speaking of Splatoon news, this past weekend we had our most recent Splatfest.
Yeah.
Where it was Team Early Bird versus Team Night Owls. And before I say anything, I hear rumors that next month is the last Splatfest.
You know
what?
I
don't know if that's true or not, but I hear words all over the internet flying. This is going to be the last one. July is going to be the last one.
You know what?
I'm like, why?
I'm not doubting that. Because...
But why?
Well,
they have a good thing going. Why would they want to screw it up?
I don't know. I don't know. But no. If you look, you're seeing it right now, folks, on the screen. These are the results right here where Callie and Marie are talking. Callie calls out Marie and she's like, look, you're talking smack all the time and stuff like that. I've won the most Splatfest or whatever. And she's like, oh, yeah, well, I won the most that counts, actually. So they're, like, having a fight. And they're like, okay, next one. I didn't know it was going to... It might be the final one. Who knows? But they're like, next one. It's all or nothing. This is the big one. So maybe it is Callie versus Marie. Are you Team Callie or Team Marie? I don't know if that's going to be the case. If it's going to be the last one, at least they're going out with a bang. I mean, I...
But as far as the scores... popularity, Night Owl took it 79% over 21% Team Early Bird.
Yeah.
Most battles won, it was a dead close one. Mm-hmm. 51% goes for Night Owls, while 49% went to Early Birds. But overall score, Night Owls won. And I'm just thinking about it now because Splatoon came out June of last year. And this is June of this year, which means that there have been 12 Splatfests exactly over this past year. Which means next month will be the 13th Splatfest.
I think there was a couple more, remember, because sometimes we get two in 1 month.
Oh, that was before I ever had Splatoon.
I think maybe we've had 16 or 15.
Oh, okay. My bad.
I think. I'm not sure exactly.
But there was a time where they had two a month.
Once in a while. Don't you remember that one time when you were playing, you were like, wow, I'm surprised there's already another Splatfest?
Every Splatfest I have had has only been once a month.
Oh.
And I had this since Christmas of last year, the Wii U.
Oh, all right. Well, c'est la vie. That looks like a...
But why? They have a good thing. I don't know.
Well, yeah. I mean...
I guess they're sick and tired of doing these free things anymore. Are they going to start charging for shit?
No. It might not be the last one, but it sounds like it from what you're hearing and what the... Because I didn't know that. I have not heard anything, but from Callie and Marie's conversation, which once again you've seen right here, folks, on the screen, I wouldn't doubt it, but the question is why, but what are they going to do in place of that, you know? Who knows? But remember, everything is starting to come to an end with the Wii U and stuff
I don't know. I hardly even played anything in the Splatfest because my connection's been absolute shit in Splatoon for some reason. Mm. Everything I have else on all my online stuff is fine. Everything else is working okay, but I don't know why. It's only when I play Splatoon is the connection's been shit.
I don't know.
I haven't hardly played it.
That's one thing
because I'm like, oh, the reason why Night Owls won is because I didn't play.
No. I mean, I don't know. That's the thing I was watching.
Because I play it the whole day. Mm-hmm. I play it the whole day.
Oh, yeah.
I only time I ever stop playing Splatfest is to get up to eat or shit.
Yeah. No, that's the thing that kind of sucks about online games that are specifically for online. Sometimes you have glorious, like, really good
it's
games.
It's still bad, my connection.
Yeah.
I'd be a level fucking 40 by now. But nope!
I mean, sometimes you have some of these great games. Like Splatoon, it has such a great idea. But once the online actually goes, like when the Wii U discontinues online eventually, whenever that'll be, then it's just a hollow shell of what it's going to be. With all online games, it's like that, that are specifically for online. And that kind of sucks. There's a lot of creative ideas, say, for example, like this. Nothing's happening anymore because the online has been taken away. You have an empty shell. And it's kind of sad, to be honest. But hey, here's open for Splatoon 2.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild is heard to have cartridge use.
Yeah.
Well, that kind of makes sense since we heard that it's already been announced that the NX is supposed to be cartridges now instead of discs. That's not confirmed, but that's already been a rumor.
Yeah, it's been
and
a
they
rumor.
They said this is going to be a cartridge use game.
Well, somewhere in the patents or something like that, or the trademark, they mention cartridges. So, once again, it could be another key into unlocking this revelous mystery. That's not a word.
Which makes me laugh because during the late 90s, early 2000s, it was the disc revolution.
Yeah.
Because the disc was what had more power and could carry more room in these games.
Oh, yeah.
Where the cartridges, you know, that was old news.
Yeah.
Time to get rid of those big old blocks and really these little discs.
That's why I was so shocked when to hear.
And I'm like,
that
okay, so now is the cartridge going to be more powerful than the disc?
It may be. Well, yeah, apparently so. That's what people are saying now, which is crazy. Cartridges can hold more than discs now. They can be more powerful, and I think they're even cheaper to make. So
then again, like, I wouldn't be surprised. Like, my Fire Emblem Fates Special Edition, all three games and one tiny little chip.
There you go. And imagine what they could do.
And those aren't small games.
No, no. And imagine what you could do within a big HD game like that. Like, what are the... That's why I was shocked when I read that, because a lot of people were like, oh, why would you do cartridges, Nintendo? Why? And some people were defending it and saying, hey, look, this has a lot more than you think. Cartridges can do so much more than they could back in the day, more than discs. So who knows? Maybe so. We'll find out.
And speaking of Zelda news, Marin will appear as a new playable character in Hyrule Warriors.
Yes.
And their newest DLC. And is this going to be the last piece of DLC for Hyrule Warriors? Or
It looks like it.
But she's going to be in both Hyrule Warriors and Hyrule Warriors Legends.
Yes, you can. It's initially going to be on Legends, but you can download it into your Wii U. So you can have her as a playable character.
Oh, you do? You download it yourself to the other game?
Yeah, yeah. I haven't done it myself, but I know that's how the process works. So you can do that, and also one thing
it's kind of like a Smash deal.
Yeah.
When you buy a DLC character, well, that means, well, you have to pay more because you're buying it for both versions, Wii U and 3DS.
Yeah, yeah.
But if you buy it on the, like, say, the Wii U, you download it on 3DS for free?
I believe so.
Or is it just like a deal package where you buy both for both systems?
I think so. I think it's the latter.
The console and the handheld.
Yeah, I think so. It's the latter. I mean, and another thing too, I forgot to mention, Marin and also Linkle, that female Link that's not really a female Link, she has a new boot power-up or something like that allows her to kick. So that's another thing, part of the DLC. So enjoy it, Legend of Zelda fans. I personally don't have it. I mean, I have Hyrule Warriors, but that's a lot of DLC to buy, and I don't have the room on my Wii U. I have yet to get a hard drive. I don't know how I've survived this long, but I need to get a hard drive for my Wii U so to get all that crap. So, yeah.
Well, dark times are coming. It's time for the cancerous ad of the week.
Oh, not the meme this time.
No, there wasn't no memes.
There was no memes for us to suck up. No cancer, so we had to resort to ads.
This is pretty justifiable because I would see it every day. I hardly watch TV, but every time when I turn on the damn TV, I see this all the time in the ads. You know those horrible ugly-ass plants called Chia Pets, where they make one of every single fucking cartoon and pop culture figure. I'm surprised there's no Sonic and Mario Chia Pet.
I think there is.
Oh, okay.
A Sonic one, I think.
Okay, then.
There's a Hedgehog one, at least, I know.
Okay, then.
I want one.
Okay, then.
Do you want one?
No.
You want a Donald Trump one?
Anyway, but there's a their newest ones is for this wonderful sideshow circus freak show that we call the United States presidential election. Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton chia pets. Wow. The perfect gift for the perfect collector who loves all that ugly ass shit. I can imagine some guy's basement. He's got like 20,000 chia pets. He's just this sick collector who has all them lined
sick
up.
Sick collector. You know what? Honestly, I wouldn't mind the Donald Trump one because that's pretty funny. You're growing Donald Trump's hair for the poor guy.
It's so ugly looking.
I know. That's why I want it just to have him water it every day. It's going to be huge. That much I can tell you.
But then again, I apologize for that remark. Sick collector. You're not sick collectors. Everyone collects weird things, weird ass shit.
What are you trying to
imply? I don't know anymore. I just hate these. And they're even like, don't forget for the collectors, don't forget your Bernie Sanders and Barack Obama chia pets. And I'm like, okay. You think that if I support Trump, you honestly think I'm gonna buy these Democrats? Chia pets.
It's a weird concept.
And,
but it's a high, you know, they are smart.
You think those are gonna sell if people are, like, so divided by these political parties? One is gonna buy the other one?
And yeah. It's just,
probably, I don't know. I don't care. It's just, I just see it all the time now. It just makes me cringe. And, you know, I don't see any Super Game Strikers chia pets.
Oh, God, that would be perfect.
And I wish you could make your own custom chia pets with your... I don't know how the fuck that would work. Bottom line, I don't care. This whole election is a complete joke.
Yeah.
The biggest joke and the biggest embarrassment in our country.
Yeah.
Which goes to show you that any idiot on this whole fucking planet can run for president.
It definitely is sad.
And I'm not supporting sides. I'm saying both sides are fucking idiots.
There's just no... Yeah.
And
nothing we can do.
So yeah, fuck that bullshit. Oh, that's your cancer sad of the week. Oh, go suck it.
Cock. I want the Garfield one, though.
I thought those things died back in 2005.
I've seen in the 90s the Garfield and stuff. Fucking animated Garfield. He's just the thumbs up. I'm like, I can't trust this man.
I'll be honest here. I
was scared?
No. I see those ads on TV all the time in the dank channels. I never seen one in real life before. Every fucking person that I go to their house, I have never seen anyone own a chia pet. Mm-hmm. I even go to all these stores, like the Home Depot, or Save Big Money at Menards, mm-hmm. or even Kmart. I've never seen a chia pet ever.
Yeah, no, me neither.
Never, ever seen one.
I mean, I've seen one.
Unless they're invisible, mm-hmm. or in the deep dark corner. I don't know. I've never seen them before.
Gotta order now.
And they say they're available in all major stores. Why are we even talking about this still? Onward the console gaming news.
That's right. Let's go.
Mighty Number 9 is out now.
Go back to the chia pets. Come on.
It came out last week on June 21st for all systems under the sun. The game met with a lot of problems, criticisms, and negative responses on everything.
On every level.
Just like Devil's Third. And apparently this game is supposed to be the spiritual successor to Mega Man. And Sean even told me, you know, since this game was highly supported and backed by the people from Kickstarter.
$4 million.
Yeah, they said a lot more money than they needed to build this game, to make it great.
You look at Shantae Half Genie Hero, which is coming out soon. That had a smaller budget, and it looks way better.
Oh, yeah. And 4 hours of credits.
4 hours.
Of all the people who supported this game. Oh, wait, I don't understand, Sean. So at the end of the game, when you beat it, the end credits is literally that long?
4 hours, the longest.
You think anyone's going to sit there and listen and look at all of them?
No. Well, listen, if you backed it and you're really that dedicated.
Can you just skip it?
I think you can.
You know, because sometimes...
I know, sometimes you can't skip.
No, yeah. or sometimes, you know, they have a secret ending after the credits. But if you skip the credits, you don't get to see that secret ending. I hope they don't pull that bullshit just to make you sit through the credits.
Oh, and that'd be terrible.
Probably not, because now, you know, people are like, don't skip the credits, don't skip the credits, because something's going to happen at the ending, but you do, nothing happens. People are like, why didn't you see the secret ending? What are you talking about? Don't skip the credits. That's what you did. Why did you do it?
Oh, man. Well, at least you have YouTube, for somebody would sit through that and then record it, so at least there's that, but...
Should I be making a fucking sandwich?
I don't think it's going to get a sequel unless of Kenji Inafune, or...
Keiji Inafune.
Yeah. Unless if he's that... devoted, but even him at the end, there's the famous word now.
He said he wanted sequels.
Oh, he wanted a friggin' TV sequels. Series and everything.
He wanted this to be big.
And you know what? I've watched so many. I am going to get the game though, because it's only $20. I still want to get it, but from what I've seen, there is Mega Man in there. It's just not Mega Man, and it's disappointed a lot of people. The hype was so high at one point. And yet, delay after delay, and it's just a big disappointment of what happened at the end, and it's just crazy, man. Also, the mouths. You know, they don't even have mouth movements, right?
That's wonderful.
When they're in shock, they have their mouth open. Kind of like PlayStation 1 era.
This big budget of a game, more $4 money.
$4 million, you can't even put, more like, money. Talking? No, it's just, like, facial reactions. It's...
Where did all that money go, then?
I don't know. A lot of strippers and cocaine. That's where it has been.
Some news for WWE 2K17. The cover athlete has been revealed, and it's none other than, to my utterly disappointment, BORK LAZER, aka Brock Lesnar.
Oh, really quick, did you get that picture I sent you?
Which one?
Be careful who you call ugly in high school.
Yeah, I forgot. Anyway,
what did you think of it?
Was that him?
Yeah,
the guy on the left, that's him?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. It's him, though. I was like, no. Anyway.
Good. Sorry, inside joke, sorry. What do you think?
I don't care anymore. I'll be honest, I'm pissed off about it. Why? Because I'm going to be the first guy, I don't care, I'll be the first guy to say it. Brock doesn't deserve to be on that fucking cover.
What do you mean? He's done so much for the company.
No, he hasn't. I'll tell you why he doesn't deserve to be on the cover.
Tell me why.
Because I don't even... I'm just going to keep this short and sweet. One, I don't even consider him to be part of the main roster. To be part of the main roster, why? Because he's a fucking part-timer. A one-trick pony part-timer piece of crap.
Oh.
He only shows... I don't even consider him to be a roster because he only shows up 3 times a year for the big 3 paper events. Royal Rumble, WrestleMania, and SummerSlam. He doesn't even show up for Survivor Series for the 4th big pay-per-view. He only shows up for 3 of them, and that's it. Then he just disappears.
Is he like a Hulk, though, type of deal, where he's like really... Is he like the biggest guy there besides Undertaker?
Size?
Like muscle-wise?
He's a big guy, but he's not the largest athlete ever.
Uh-huh. Well, I know, anyway, not the large, but I mean now.
You know, the hype was crazy when he came back, but you know what? He's bland as fuck now. He's boring as fuck. And I call him a one-trick pony because, oh, okay, he beat John Cena using the same move 30 times. That was it. And they call it Suplex City. You know, okay, that was cool and funny the first time. But since you're doing it now in every single match you do, that's all he does in every single match.
It's just suplexes?
Yeah, that's all he does. Then does the F5, and that's it. That's all he does in the ring.
Oh, boy.
You know, and, you know, I wasn't even wowed by him to begin with, now that I think about it, when he was there back in 2003, because he hardly had any moves. All he did was shoulder you in the corner and... pound you a couple of times and hit you with the F5. I'm like, okay, that's great. And, you know, because Vince McMahon, you know, that freak has a hard-on for big guys. So, you know, if you look at his track record. And, you know, I'm going to be the first to say it. You know, even Roman Reigns. Yes, I said it. Roman Reigns. He deserves to be on the cover more than BORK LAZER. Piece of shit LAZER. Even he does, because you know what? Whether you people like him or hate him, you gotta admit, he's a good worker. He actually deserves it, because day in, and night out, he actually pulls hell of a matches. He's been having wars in the ring. He's been pulling A-plus stuff against guys like Seth Rollins and AJ Styles. And he's been stepping up. No matter if you guys stomp on him and hate him and despise him, you gotta admit, he delivers each night at least.
I'm feeling the passion.
So... you know, fuck Lesnar. you know, fucking one trick. That's why I call him a one trick pony.
He's behind you.
I'm not scared of him. I'm scared of it.
He looks like a fucking decapitated rhinoceros.
Look, no, you want a good laugh, Sean? Go on YouTube and type in Brock Lesnar scream compilation videos. And it shows all the time of him screaming and stuff. And it sounds like a third grade girl, a little girl in third grade, screaming because someone took her crayon away. Or even a kindergartner.
Oh, boy.
You know? Or even some kind of sick bird.
I remember... Okay, sick bird.
He sounds like he sounded like some kind of parakeet or one of those big birds.
Ooh.
With a mating call and he was screaming. It was like... Ah!
His face looks funny.
You know, so whatever, fucking roided-ass freak. And whatever.
Has Undertaker ever been on one of the covers?
As
a main person, like the only...
Well...
Or he's just been on...
In 2008, he was in the cover, but he had to share it with John Cena and another wrestler. Right. But he was in the middle. The main focus was on him.
Oh, okay.
His face in the middle. And in 2010, he had to share it with 5 other wrestlers, and he was in the corner. Looking all under...
He's your favorite, right? Or... Not anymore? Or
no,
was
no,
he?
No. It depends on the time era.
You like him in his biker days, don't you?
I like him in everything.
Oh, okay.
I liked him when he was crucifying people on crosses.
Well,
I used to like the 90s. Oh, I was afraid of him when he used to give his little dark sermons and worship the devil.
Okay.
And stuff.
All right.
And
well,
all of them came on their little robes. And
so he's your favorite then? Or no? Or who's
him, him and Kane back in his day. Kane back in his day.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
What about now, though? Anything?
Or he needs just to watch it for the fun? He needs to retire.
No, I mean you liking somebody now. Like, who's your favorite now?
Oh, my favorite? Dean Ambrose, Seth Rollins, and Roman Reigns. Those three.
Oh, okay.
Yes, I said it. Roman Reigns included.
There you go. Stand up to the man.
And you know what, too? I'm just going to say it right now. Let's be honest. I'm going to be honest here. Let's
come
be
on!
Honest. I got other big news, too. I like Resident Evil 6.
Oh, yeah.
And be sure to tune in next
week go over this.
As I do a rant about this, as a second rant, follow up on my my rant for Resident Evil 7.
What's his face?
And also, you know what else too? You know what else too? After thinking about it, Sonic 06 was an alright game as well.
You are going past the limits.
There, I said it.
It wasn't that bad though.
It wasn't that bad. You know why? You know why it wasn't that bad? Because you had to, like Sega Sean said, you had to get good.
Get good.
For you people out there, get good.
It's true. Get good.
Of course, it's gonna has a flaws. It has a million flaws.
It has flaws.
It has just as much as flaws, as it has just as much bad flaws as it does good flaws. You know, but sometimes you know people just look at the negatives, then they do the positives. You gotta look at both and weigh in.
Oh, it's
true.
Because
that balance. And that's when I saw the light when I was playing Resident Evil 6, you know. And back in my days when I was a gullible college student, I just listened to what everybody said. I was like, "Oh, game's trash. Don't play it. Don't waste your money."
That's the thing that's crazy too that I didn't get to mention.
Because I knew
in the Sonic podcast, I wanted to mention, but we were going way too over. The thing about the internet is that when it was 2006, I believe that's when I started going on there. I thought that Sonic was all right. I thought he was loved by a lot of people. And that still holds true. But all of a sudden I started like, wow, you know, people say that the Sonic Heroes was the fault of the series and stuff. Like, people started hating on it and stuff like that. It's all due to the internet. I mean, everyone's entitled to their own opinions, but the way how they over-inflame everything, it doesn't make sense. Poor game developers are like, I cannot imagine the stress they go through to make a game. Any game developer, and only to just get it a 2 out of 10 shoved in your face. You did your part. I mean, I'm not standing up for every game, but every game had some love put into it, whether it was at the beginning of development or even at the end as a last push. You have to look at a whole game as a whole and really consider, do you think that you're one person is actually worthy to just give a score like that, smack a score on something or whatever? You know, Sonic and
no,
Leash
you're
got
an
a,
idiot.
You know,
for following
Sonic,
that.
Sonic
you're
and Leash
an
got
idiot.
A lower score than Sonic 06. That's how much sense that makes. Sonic and Leash was way more polished and stuff. Yes, it has its flaws. Every game has flaws, and some others, and whatever. Every
game. I may like Resident Evil 6, but it doesn't mean I'm saying it's a perfect game. No, hell no. It is far from perfect. Exactly. It's got tons of flaws. It's got tons of problems.
Exactly.
But I'm just saying, after playing it myself,
yeah,
it's not as bad as people blow it out to be. Mm-hmm. Those people can blow it out their ass saying, you know, saying, oh, it's the worst thing ever. Yeah. But, you know,
it killed the series. I'll agree,
you know, I'll agree with everybody still about one thing. The cover is shit.
Yeah.
With the six. But, you know, like I always say, you know, a blow job is better than no job.
You never said that in your life. But it's true. And people make such a big deal out of things or whatever. And yes, we are doing our own.
Blow it out of proportion.
You know, yeah.
I played it myself, and I loved it. I wasted 4 fucking years not playing this thing.
Did you bleed? Did you cry? Did you hate it that much? No, you liked it.
I'm addicted.
It's fun. It's fun. And when I played the demo, I liked
it. I haven't beaten the game yet. I'm close to it, though. I'm close. But I'm honestly considering changing my top 10.
Resident Evil 6 or Resident Evil
top
games.
10 Resident Evil games that I did for the 20th anniversary.
Man, remember the past when you said it was shit.
I'll admit, I'm not ashamed to say it. Horribly misjudged it.
Live and learn.
I horribly misjudged it.
That's why our lists are probably going to be very different from other people's, because we look outside the box. It doesn't have to be all in one place.
So yeah, terrible. You know.
Sorry for the little outbreak here.
Bottom line.
Riled up on that.
Bottom line, you know, fuck those people and fuck Brock Lesnar. How even at this point, Cena's more deserving to be on the cover.
But you can't see him, so.
then Bork Laser.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, like I said, the hype was crazy when he returned, but now ever since he shows up 3 times a year. If you're lucky, 4 times. Mm-hmm. But that's asking too much for him. You know, he comes back. Okay, great. Bring the bell. Here comes a German. Another German.
I thought Goldberg would be on the cover.
Nah.
Because he's not in it. So no. They have to have somebody that's
they
in
the
show.
They had the DLC fighters. So, yeah. Like I said, I thought it'd be Reigns. Because he's the top dog right now. Well, now he's suspended. But... for drugs, but
yeah.
I don't know. Like I said, I thought to me, he's more well deserving because he's been a hard worker. That's all I'm going to say. All right, and you know what else too? Fuck it, I'm going to say it. Takeshi's Challenge was an all right game.
It's going a bit too far.
I
think we're on a sugar high there. That's fine.
You know, you people had to get good at that.
I mean, yeah.
You're supposed to leave your wife. You're supposed to go.
Oh God, no.
And if you lose and you got to start all over again, that's your own fucking fault.
We were serious though about saying like Resident Evil 6 and stuff.
Everything else I'm serious.
Those are serious,
challenge.
Even though it sounds like we're joking. No, we're serious.
No, that lad, that was a troll. Takeshi's Challenge.
Oh, that
was the joke.
No, I was like, what are you doing? No.
My little rant about Bork Laser being on the cover of the next wrestling game, and what else? Sonic 06 and Resident Evil 6. I'm dead serious about.
Yes, we are.
Those I'm dead serious about. Anyway, be sure you guys check... Oh, Balrog
is sent. We have more, right?
A couple of things.
Okay.
Balrog is set to be the newest Street Fighter character to appear in Street Fighter V coming out this coming Friday.
Yes.
And how many fighters do they have now? Is it 5?
Wait, let me really think about this. Ryu.
Not
count
a whole
with,
lot.
Count me.
Ryu, Ken.
Shit.
Bison.
Chun-Li. All right. Guile. Bison, Chun-Li, Guile.
Zangief.
Who's
the dude with the dreadlocks?
I don't know that guy's name. I haven't played the game.
That Chinese dude with the mask.
Fang. Fang.
The girl.
Laura. Yeah.
The wrestler girl.
Rainbow Mika, Cammy. That's 10 so far. Oh, God. All right. It's not that much.
That's a wonderful roster.
Rashido.
So who's that other guy that everyone says is like Brock Lesnar? He came back. He was an old character.
Oh, Alex? I believe that's his name. Yeah. And also,
it's not Street Fighter without Dan.
Yeah, we need Dan back. He'll probably show up as a terrible the final DLC character. We need him. Also, with Balrog, also what was teased at the end of the trailer...
I don't mean to interrupt you, but is Balrog an old character a new character? I have never heard of him.
Yeah, he was one of the bosses.
I don't remember. I've played Street Fighter in eons.
Oh, in the original Street Fighter 2... he was one of the bosses, along with M. Bison and, I think, Sagat. He's not in Street Fighter V either. He's the main... Sagat was one of... whatever. But what was teased at the end of the Balrog trailer, I didn't watch it until yesterday.
Great game. I heard the online's even wonderful.
Oh, it's getting better.
so much these days.
You know, Jury and a guy I cannot remember the name of because he's from, I think, the Alpha series... Jury from Street Fighter 4 is coming as well. She's got a new outfit, like totally new, shows off her ass. I love it. Although she's a real... I think she's a freak in bed. But anyway, she is weird. She's like one of those girls that like teases you and stuff, and then she's like, yeah, I'll rip it off. But anyway, yeah, this is your Street Fighter 5 news straight from the horse's mouth.
Be sure to check out our Indie PopCon video.
Yeah, that came out yesterday.
If you guys have not seen that, please check it out as well.
Link popping up now.
And, we had a great time. Just a little quick recap and some of our highlights. My top three highlights, I'm going to have to say, is meeting Charles Martinet. Equally to also meeting Lloyd Kaufman. That was one of the greatest fucking things in my life. Mm-hmm. And getting my modded N64 console.
Okay.
Which is my very first N64.
Oh, all right.
So I can play banjo.
Oh, yeah. How are you enjoying that, by the way? Are you getting farther or no?
Who? Oh, banjo.
Who?
I'm a third of the way done.
Oh, wow. Okay. All right. I guess my top three, I didn't think about it. Definitely Charles is number one. I cannot beat meeting him. What else? I honestly didn't meet a lot. Well, Tara Strong, that was nice to meet her. She wasn't one of my top people to meet, but yeah, so that was nice. And,
I'll be honest, she looked like a porn star.
She was...
She looked like a porn star.
The gazangas star. Were bigger than... They were big. What do you
think? Yeah.
I did not... When she stepped out, like, because she stepped in front of the, autograph thing, everyone, like, I could tell, even Barry was like... Like, and we were all like, oh, and you're like, settle down, boy.
I know.
Well, I was like, oh.
No, boys, don't touch
this. No, boys. What's this icky paint like? Go, it's moving. No, boys, don't touch the. Oh, diarrhea. It's hitting again. Oh, God, I can't even think. Just the whole time in general, even outside the con was just a blast. At the hotel and stuff, eating Uno pizza and stuff. It was just so fun. I really can't. Charles is definitely number one, but then everything else just comes after. There's really no list for me. It was just really fun. Check out the video, definitely.
All right. There are some of our highlights. If you want to see the whole thing, be sure to check that out, as well as our haul video.
Yes. That'll be coming tomorrow, and I'm just wanting you guys... It's huge. This is getting split up.
So we got a whole slew of stuff coming out this week. So brace yourselves.
Lots.
On that note, please be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe to the Super Game Strikers. And be sure to like us on Game Strikers on
Facebook.
And be sure to like and subscribe to Super Game Strikers Play, our...
Let's Play channel.
Our separate Let's Play channel, starring my co-host Sega Sean and Retro Nick.
Yeah, he's there.
And because of that, we got everything now. We have podcasts, rants, unboxings, sub-specials, convention videos.
And more!
Haul videos, random bits, and now Let's Plays. How awesome is that? All we need now is a food channel, and I think we're set.
What is with this food channel? Oh.
All we need is a food channel, and we're pretty much... Unstoppable.
We're pretty much.
Unstoppable at this point.
I think we should take up knitting. I think that's an upcoming thing.
This is Kaiju Lou.
And Sega Sean.
Take care, folks, and stay tuned.
Bye-bye.